We continued to follow the case of Brian, who presented to me following a blackout. Brian sustained injuries in a motor vehicle accident and had surgery to fix a fracture in his upper arm. Unfortunately, as we will hear, things did not go well for Brian over the next few weeks. Let's go back to hear from Sally, who is a general surgeon at the hospital and is looking after Brian following the surgery.
Hi, I'm Sally and I'm Brian's general surgeon. According to the handover we received from the orthopaedic team, Brian's surgery went well and he was taken back to the ward once he'd woken up. However, several hours after returning to the ward, he complained of left-sided abdominal pain. His pulse rate started to rise, so the ward team gave him more analgesia and started to wonder if he'd perhaps suffered internal injuries in the accident, so they called us in. Sometimes you get injury to the organs, such as the spleen, from the seatbelt, so that was our first thought. We decided a CT scan would be the best way to determine if this was the case. So a CT scan of the abdomen was arranged, and sure enough, he had a subcapsular hematoma of the spleen. We decided to manage it conservatively because he was hemodynamically stable. But later that day, he became hypotensive and he was rushed to surgery and the spleen was removed. It took longer than usual because we had difficulty controlling the bleeding and he needed 10 units of blood in the end. Postoperatively, he had a stint in the high dependency unit overnight and then came back to the ward. Brian didn't recover as well as expected and started to spike high temperatures. The wound looked fine, so a wound infection was unlikely. There was no chest infection or urinary tract infection. Two of the three blood cultures grew strep pyogens.